If you were asked to think of a creature that takes big risks, a bird might not be the first thing that comes to mind. Like, if the two options are fight or flight, and you're a bird, you'll probably pick flight. But there are a few bird species that don't chicken out when faced with a tough situation. From storm chasers to fire eaters to a species that will literally stop for nothing, and I mean nothing, to reach their final destination, let's talk about some of the biggest avian daredevils around. The desertous petrel is a rare seabird that makes its home in the North Atlantic. The only known colony of these birds can be found nesting on the Bugio Island off the western coast of North Africa. These crow-sized birds spend most of their time over the open ocean searching for food. One of the perils of life as a seabird is having to live through hurricanes and tropical storms, which are happening more and more as our planet continues to get warmer. Most seabirds will avoid storms because the high winds and large waves can do a lot of damage. The birds will either hide out in their nests, seek refuge in the calmer eye of the storm, or avoid the storm altogether by flying around it. But not the desertous petrel. This bird deliberately follows active storms. Apparently, it's not just humans who are storm chasers. In a recent study, researchers tracked the movements of these birds and found that they travel thousands of kilometers to keep up with a storm. The birds were routinely tracked to stormy locations, with waves reaching 8 meters high and winds up to 100 kilometers an hour. And they engage in this shockingly dangerous behavior for a good reason. Food. These birds eat fish, squid, and crustaceans, all of which you'd normally find hundreds of meters below the surface of the ocean, at least during the day. And while petrels are great flyers, they're not as good at diving. So they usually have to wait to chow down until nighttime, when their prey migrates to the surface to feed. But at some point, these birds discovered that chasing a storm might be another way to get a meal. See, as a storm moves over the ocean, the winds draw colder water up from the depths, dropping surface temperatures. The cooler waters become rich in plankton, which happens to be a food source for the petrel's prey. This change in surface conditions draws the bird's prey up from the depths to feed, where they become easy pickings for the petrels from there. As a bonus, the storms help the birds conserve energy. Instead of actively flying, they just glide along, bolstered by the strong winds. It's safe to say that the desertous petrel has found a silver lining in the storm clouds. And it's filled with fish! But birds won't just risk it all for a meal. Some will put their life and wing on the line for their families, too. Killdeer are a bird species with an unusually laissez-faire nesting strategy. They just dig a little hole in the ground and lay some eggs in it. Sometimes they even skip the digging part altogether and just make a nest in a clump of grass in a parking lot or an open field. But despite their lackadaisical nesting strategies, adult killdeer are willing to risk their own lives to protect their babies from potential predators. If a predator approaches, the adults will flop around on the ground to make it look like they have a broken wing. The predator is enticed away from the nest by the promise of an easy meal. But joke's on them, because once the predator is far away from the nest, the parent is suddenly cured of its injury and flies away to safety. This risky behavior could easily go wrong if the bird gets too caught up during the performance and gets snagged by a predator during their theatrics. But it seems to work out well enough that other birds have caught on to the grift too. Researchers have found that this strategy has evolved dozens of times in 52 different bird families. It seems safe to say that for some birds, the key to survival is in acting the part. Bravo! Now, let's talk about an even riskier strategy that birds use to beat predators. Mobbing. Mobbing is when a bunch of birds gang up on a predator that's eyeing their nest or getting too close for comfort. Using a safety in numbers approach to overwhelm the bigger bird, the adults scare the potential predators off to keep their babies safe. But mobbing isn't without its risks. While the overall mob might be fine, some individual birds may not make it if the predator is especially feisty. Which is crazy, because research now suggests that sometimes birds will choose to start mobbing a predator just to show off. And this isn't limited to a particular species. Lots of birds choose to do this. But I say, one of the most daring matchups is hummingbird versus owl? I mean, hummingbirds are feisty, no doubt about it, but it feels like a particularly risky decision for something that tiny to dive bomb an owl purely for the sake of impressing the opposite sex. Researchers figured this out by setting out models of two different owl species to see how the birds would act when predators were near. Specifically, they compared the hummingbird's reaction to a pygmy owl, which regularly snacks on small birds, and a burrowing owl, which does not. The hummingbirds did increase their mobbing behavior when more females were around, but went for the less dangerous burrowing owl over the pygmy owl. Female hummingbirds use this risky behavior to judge how good a potential mate will be at protecting the nest or finding food. So the males take a risk, purely to show off their skills for a future mate. Yeah, sure, it's safer than mobbing the owl that actually wants to eat you, but dive bombing a predatory bird when you're snack-sized isn't exactly a genius move. Just imagine if dating involved running up to a lion and pulling its tail. That's basically what these hummingbirds are doing. Because nothing says I'm a good provider quite like risking becoming the main course.
This SciShow video is supported by our own stuff. I don't know if you've noticed this, but we've been really going all in on rocks this year. Every month, we've made a video about a specific rock that subscribers to the SciShow Rocks box will receive at their door. But we know that there are way more people who love rocks than the number of Rocks box subscribers, so we have other rock merch for y'all. There's premium rocks like polished ammolite that looks like stained glass, but they're rocks and I don't even really know how that's possible. And for you self-starters out there who want to find and gawk at your own rocks, there's a 30 times magnification jeweler's loop on sale at complexly.store. Find it all at complexly.store/scishow or at the link in the description.
Next up is a bird with an unmatched determination to reach its final destination, no matter the risks. Meet the barred-tailed godwit, a bird that holds the Guinness World Record for the longest non-stop flight ever taken by a bird. They can cover over 13,000 kilometers, or nearly 9,000 miles, over a 9-day period. And they won't stop for anything. Not food, water, or even rest. They fly this ultra-marathon to get from their nesting grounds in Alaska to New Zealand in one shot, most of which is over the Pacific Ocean with few opportunities to land. And they don't even glide, which would be way less energetically costly. They are actively flapping their wings almost the entire time. Researchers have theories as to why they have evolved to make these extreme nonstop flights, with the most plausible being that their two homes are both just too good to give up forever. The birds migrate to whichever hemisphere is experiencing summer, breeding in Alaska when it's warm, and then trekking down to New Zealand to avoid the harsh Alaskan winters. Both of these places have plenty of food and few predators, so it makes sense that they seem like great places to call home, if you can get past that agonizing commute, which apparently they can. As to why they do it all in one shot versus breaking up the flight, researchers think that the birds may have once followed routes that allowed them to take breaks, but these stopping points no longer exist as our planet's geography has changed, which means natural selection would favor birds capable of making long flights. Now, completing this long of a journey with zero fuel to replace what's being burned is a huge risk for a bird that only weighs a few ounces to begin with. So they make sure to pack on the ounces ahead of the trip. In the time leading up to this lengthy migration, they'll increase their body fat to over 50% of their entire weight by the time they take off. Now, you might have some questions, like, why isn't Fat Bird Week a thing? Then, about a month before takeoff, their gizzards, livers, kidneys, and guts all decrease in size while their hearts and flight muscles increase. You heard me, their digestive organs shrink so they can stay airborne. Since these birds are literally just flying for more than a week, they save a little metabolic energy by shutting off the superfluous process, like digestion. Once they've arrived at their destination, their organs return to their normal size. At least, until it's time to make the trek all over again. Honestly, I can barely get through a 5-hour road trip without snacks. These birds are out here showing us all up. The last birds on our list take playing with fire to a whole new level. Rufous tree pies are a species of corvid found in places like Pakistan and India. They are excellent scavengers who won't turn up their beaks at most food items. But in 2017, birders at Josh Shore Wildlife Sanctuary observed tree pies eating something they did not expect. They were out birding near a temple inside the sanctuary when they saw the temple's caretaker feed the birds that were hanging around, including several tree pies. And afterwards, he went inside to light prayer lamps in the temple. Once the caretaker was gone, the birders saw the tree pies enter the temple, steal the lit lamps, remove the still-burning wicks from those lamps, and then extinguish the flames so they could eat them. These birds were eating fire. Well, Close enough, anyway. And the reason why is actually pretty brilliant. The tree pies had figured out that the fuel in the prayer lamps was ghee, aka clarified butter. So those ghee-soaked wicks started looking like a delicious snack, as long as they could get past the whole being on fire thing. But with a few sharp shakes of their heads, they can put the fire out and enjoy their buttery treat. Now, some raptors are known to use fire to flush out prey, but this is the first time a bird has been observed eating something that itself was recently on fire. Not only does this speak to the high intelligence of this species, but it also proves, yet again, that butter is delicious. Some of these risk-taking birds may come off a bit bird-brained at first glance. Hummingbirds, I'm looking at you. But when you dig a bit deeper, you'll see the bravery and innovation behind their decisions. From storm-chasing seabirds to fire-eating scavengers, each bird demonstrates that sometimes bold behavior comes in small packages. So the next time you see a bird in the wild, don't assume it's a shy, fragile creature. It might just be gearing up for its next big, risky adventure.